tell us a little bit about the moped, which is right now just below us, and we can show you that footage live here at CES. What exactly is this machine supposed to do?
To introduce moped, I really like to talk about some story. At the first time, you know, I studied legged robot previously, but a lot of people asked me to how to make a long operation time, energy consumption less, something like that. And then another thing is actually legged robot has really strong advantage because, you know, they can stabilize its body by utilizing leg. And so how to combine the characteristics of leg robot and wheeled robot, because it less energy consumption, right? And then that led to the moped. So we developed the moped.
And so I can see that the top is pretty flat. Our viewers can watch it right there. Mm-hmm. So this is also used for that last mile delivery.
Right.
Actually using it in real life practices. When are the deliveries expected? How many are you expecting for this year?
Who knows the future? But I think, in my opinion, so they're going to be all cars soon, because, you know, because right now a lot of people is doing some research for the autonomous driving with some unique mechanism delivery robot, right? So for example, moped has some, you know, a strong advantage about some stabilizing its base body. And so it can adapt to the rough terrain in outdoors, right? With some autonomous driving algorithm, it can deliver by itself to some door-to-door delivery services. So moped has really, you know, smart navigation algorithm powered by AI.
How many are you producing this year?
So 4 years. Because actually, you know, in CES 2022, we unveiled the concept of moped. Right after that, a lot of people asked us to prepare for the mass production about the moped. So right now we brought the moped. That is the mass production ready product right now. So we have a plan to sell in the first quarter of this year.
You already have these orders in?
Yeah, actually we did, and but you know, it's kind of confidential, but a lot of people asked me to prepare for their order. And actually on the top of the moped there is some mounting rail. That means some payload can be attached to the top of the moped. So a lot of people just, you know, add their own payload to the moped for their own purpose.
So it's like very adaptable is your point, right?
Right.
That's the point, right? We're seeing a lot of gadgets and a lot of innovation here at CES. Mm-hmm. The question is, will this really make it in practical, real-life situations? Mm-hmm. When you compare what Hyundai is doing, what South Korean Robotics is doing, how does it stack up in the global race in this sector, especially against perhaps the Chinese?
Yeah, actually Chinese company has a really large size of market, so that is definitely really strong point. Also, you know, recently, you know, there are a lot of great research about the AI, so that kind of thing makes some average level of AI. So a lot of engineers can apply some AI application with some tool for the AI. So that kind of thing makes some standard really high. So Chinese company looks like really promising right now, but I can dare say a lot of people know how to do that. But we have to find some application or successful story with robotic solutions. So I think it's an open question yet. Mm-hmm. So the engineer and entrepreneur have to, you know, try our best right now to open the market right now.
Are we going towards the trend of humanoids, which is another big buzz right now? And even Hyundai's Boston Dynamics unit just released the Atlas humanoid robot. Are you collaborating with Boston Dynamics at all? Or does Robotics Lab have plans for a humanoid?
Yeah, so as an engineer, I think technology have to flow to each other. So we share the under the level of some research side. So we just share the technology, and sometimes we learn from the Boston Dynamics. Also, we let the Boston Dynamics know our strengths. So, but you know, our target market is different, and regarding to humanoid, I think, you know, basically, you know, the first problem is mobility. Second problem term is manipulation. The mobility plus manipulation can be humanoid, right? But right now, I think in the research level, we have to go a long way, because, you know, a lot of people expect the humanoid can do everything, but as an engineer, that kind of thing will happen someday, because a lot of engineers try their best, right, including me. But, you know, technology, you know, improve continuously, and then we just follow up state of the art right now. But someday, humanoid can do work there, you know, just a task, I think.
Is it more feasible than what, say, Chairman Jung In-sun was talking about when he visited Samsung, yeah, and then he was talking about the cleaning robots and how he thinks that he can combine it with MoBit, for example, to even make them better? How would that look like?
I think it is a really interesting project, because basically robotics is, you know, kind of interdisciplinary project. So I think we have to try combine every technology for each application. So cleaning is a really interesting project, I think, because, you know, in case of the Korea, we have a really serious social problem, such as labor shortage, right? So we can just, you know, replace the shortage of the labor with robotics technology. For example, cleaning is really interesting, right? Nobody wanna just clean the room continuously, right?